There's nothing to be done to make liberation happen. There's no one that could do anything. Not only that, it works both ways. There's nothing that can be done to stop liberation from happening. That's scary for the separate sense of self. This already is liberation anyway. Exactly. Nothing needs to be done. No. No. They told me who you were and who you expected me to be. Utter hopelessness and despair. Well. So for the mind, there seems to be no way out. Apparently, a lot of people go to the meetings asking questions, but they don't seem to really hear the answer. It doesn't sink in. They just say, yes, or right. Or just, thank you, and so on. But really, aren't they just stumped? Their minds confused, or pissed off even? That guy, Tony, never gets what I mean when I ask a question. He doesn't concede a single point. Some people almost seem to want to be thanked. Like they want a, oh yeah, I never thought of that, thank you. Stupid. Of course I exist. I didn't see it that way. Oh shit, sorry guys. Gotta end the meeting here. I was wrong. You can go back to your lives now.
This energy, and you say it in words.
Four foot nothing, me staying with Earth when we went hiding. Why don't you see?
Okay, so it's not
no one came looking for me.
There's a dynamic about this message from you.
Your head is restless with greed.
You are the first one. That doesn't have this dynamic.
She carried on shoulders like a little king. She is worshipped and adored. Invisibly worshipped and ignored. No one came looking for me.
What you see in the world is this this personal endeavor. It's all about personal endeavor. It's all about the person finding something, achieving something. There's nothing to achieve except the realization that there's nothing to achieve.
When I first read your book, I kind of had two reactions. One was I became kind of profoundly depressed. Then the other reaction was to laugh till I cried.
I think it's nonsense.
In one sense, it's like tremendously funny. And in the other sense, because you have to surrender what you've always kind of cherished, you feel profoundly depressed at first.
Yes.
So if I'm interested in saving the virgin forests and eating healthy and sustainable living,
yeah,
whatever I was interested in before, I'll still be interested in.
You could be.
Or will that change?
You could be. But the only thing that can happen, like this guy over here was talking about being depressed, is that what can happen initially is the realization that your life is totally meaningless. The idea that somewhere that you can make something of your life and make it work for you work. And then what arises is this awakening, and then what arises out of that is the total celebration of life by no one. So that the work that you did before possibly could go on being done, but it would just be a celebration instead of an obligation or a need to find something. We are driven by the longing to find oneness. And everything we do is towards that. It isn't your problems that will fall away.
Right.
That which believed it had problems will fall away.
Nothing to cover up, but I think it's bureaucratical bullshit!
Oneness stands there saying, is oneness tormenting?
Seems crazy.
Oh, to the mind. For the mind, what is being said here is absolute craziness.
From the top, boys, a 5, 6, 7, 8.
The difficulty with this is apparent Advaita teachers talk about oneness. There is only oneness, there is not two-ness. And then go on talking to somebody about what they can do about finding that.
Exactly.
That is the divine misconception.
Yes. Except that there are people, they're sitting here listening and everything's fine, but we're going to walk out here and say fuck you to everybody in traffic.
Absolutely, but who's going to do that?
Okay.
What you're saying is that there's someone there who can choose to say fuck you to everyone.
I have no problem with any of that.
But there's no one there that can... If there's somebody there that can say fuck off to everybody, is there also somebody there that can find enlightenment? No. Neither can happen. There's no one.
I understand, but I have no problem with saying fuck you to anyone, but I have a problem with saying... The people that say afterwards, you shouldn't have done that. And that is a personal self coming in with a so-called, you know...
Well, if you listen to that, then you're fascinated by the idea that there's someone there who can become someone who doesn't say fuck off. Advaita can't be taught. Advaita is being. There is oneness. How can anyone teach that?
And it's interesting because some of the things that you say, the mind is literally just like stunned. It's stunned because it can't go there, and that's why you said it's a real conversation stopper.
Because it's beyond the mind.
Yeah, well,
what
anyway.
You are is beyond the mind.
Once again, here is how it should sound. How do you do? And here's how you sound.
What's the distinction between what's apparent and what's real?
They're both the same thing. Apparently nothing is happening. Nothing is happening. This is the appearance of nothing happening.
But so something is happening.
No, you think it's happening. The individual would think this is happening, that's happening, and that's happening. The individual sees this and puts it together as a photograph. It's one image, and the mind puts it, that image next to that one, and that one, and that one, and calls it a story. There's no story.
Now try it again.
How do you do?
What did you say?
The life of the wife is ended by the knife.
Those flowers are being flowering.
Right, so that's what's happening.
No, it's what appears. When there is no one there, that will be seen. But someone being there is being
seen. Being there, right, I understand. So, and there's nothing I can do about...
There is no one.
Okay, there's nothing...
And that's what happens.
Yeah.
That's what happens. The mind, when people go on hearing this, as obviously they do more in Europe and so on, because I speak to a lot of, the mind goes on saying, yeah, but what about, no, hold on, yeah, but what about, oh, fuck it.
So, as long as there is the sense of an individual being here, there is no hope of me seeing the distinction
Absolutely.
Between
no,
apparent and real.
None.
So I shouldn't even try to figure it out.
No.
That, how come he's saying nothing is happening Absolutely. When something is really happening?
Yeah.
So I just give that up.
Yeah. Well, no, you can't give it up either.
Well,
who's going to give it up?
Right. So until that gets given up, there is no hope of seeing...
None at all.
And there's nothing that can be done about it?
None, nothing.
Okay.
Construct of the personal, the apparently separate person, is illusory or dreamlike.